Hi, this is Barb Eichinger from Future Plus Systems, and welcome to our short presentation on how to protect your critical applications from the known failure mechanism in DDR3 called Row Hammer. Row Hammer has been recently thrust into the spotlight by a Google article that showed how this failure mechanism can be a security risk. We here at Future Plus see it not only as a security risk, but as a general reliability issue. DDR3 memory is everywhere, from cloud computing, to aviation, to automotive, and even cell phones. In many cases, software repeatedly accesses a single location as a means of communication between I/O devices or different tasks or threads running on a system. Charge leakage can cause multi-bit corruption of physically adjacent memory locations, and ECC will not save you. ECC is single-bit detection and correction, and double-bit detection. Anything beyond two errors in a single row will be undetected. There are several mitigation techniques that are currently being used. The most common is to double the refresh rate. This causes the memory controller to refresh the adjacent or victim rows more frequently, thus making charge leakage less of a problem. However, doubling your refresh rate on DDR3 causes a performance hit and more power consumption. This may not be a viable solution for all applications, especially embedded applications that are very time sensitive and need to have accesses occur quickly. Critical applications should be tested to see if they create the row hammer event. So how can I test if my application creates the row hammer event? Well, the DDR detective sits silently in the system DIMM slot and monitors all traffic to and from the DIMM. Its row hammer event feature statistically counts the activate commands to the various row addresses and indicates when or if the software running causes the number of activate commands to exceed the MAC, or the maximum activation count, to a single row address. The MAC value for the DIMM is found in the DIMM's SPD. The DDR detective allows for two thresholds to be set, so users can see not only if they're getting close to the MAC, but if they exceed the actual MAC value. In March of 2015, Google posted some row hammer test code on GitHub. Let's run it. We'll be running this on a Micron P8, P67, M Pro with a DDR3 DIMM from Micron with this part number. The refresh rate of the system is set to 1x. That is, a refresh command will appear on the bus approximately every 7.8 microseconds. The SPD from the DIMM says that the MAC is unspecified. This means that the DIMM gives no reliability information with regards to its row hammer robustness. Here's the DDR detective setup screen. Let's set up the address range to cover all banks and ranks on this particular DIMM. Then let's set up the threshold limits. Let's set threshold 1 to 300,000 and threshold 2 to 450,000. The data display parameter controls how often the display will be refreshed. The tool also has a data report output. The output lists the exact row address that exceeded the two threshold values within the 64 millisecond for normal temperature or 32 millisecond for high temperature retention cycle. You can change the retention time here. Here's the DDR Detective Row Hammer output screen. With this display, you can visualize the actual banks, ranks, and rows of the DIMM. The blue indicates when the number of activates exceeds threshold 1. Red is when threshold 2 is exceeded. The actual row addresses are listed here. After you stop the tool, you can replay the information second by second. This tool is the only tool on the market that actually counts the activate commands that cause the row hammer failure. Probing is available for most any applications that use DDR3 memory, DIMM, SODIMM, custom midbus applications, or memory down. So in summary, critical applications should test to see if their software creates the row hammer event. By the way, the DIMM we were using did fail the Google test code. Future Plus Systems has the only tool on the market that sits silently on the memory bus and counts the actual activate commands created by the software. The DDR Detective is being deployed into test labs and is available for purchase or for rent. So if you want to see if your critical application is capable of creating Row Hammer event, please contact us. We'd be happy to help. For more information, check out our websites. And thanks again for viewing our video.